remember, for us, the drum was the hack, right? Get kids' attention, time spent listening, get them really engaged. Either way, we've created this learning platform to serve this growing industry. And I know that benefits everybody.
You're listening to the Drone Radio Show podcast, the show about drones and the people who use them for business, fun, and research. Hosted by Randy Goers.
Hello, everyone. This is Randy Goers, and welcome to the Drone Radio Show podcast, episode 417. How is drone technology making STEM education more accessible and fun for students of all backgrounds? For that question, we head to Paramount, California, to speak with Rob Harvey, Executive Chairman and co-founder of For The Win Robotics. For The Win Robotics fosters critical thinking and lifelong curiosity through the power of experiential STEM and computer science education. With its Build, Fly, Code program, the company has developed an innovative education system offering educators new professional development opportunities while making STEM and computer science education fun for learners. For The Win Robotics is currently used in more than 1,000 schools across the United States. By promoting collaboration, critical thinking, and curiosity, For The Win is building essential skills that today's students need to become the workforce of the future. Rob is a visionary brand builder with more than 20 years of experience elevating unique voices and guiding industry leaders to new technologies. As an executive within the music industry, he defined mainstream culture by breaking 50 number one songs and promoting artists like Taylor Swift, The Weeknd, Drake, and Eminem. He held influential positions at two major record labels before transitioning to Spotify, where he leveraged real-time data, consumer insights, and customer feedback to champion new business models and elevate brands globally. In the process, Rob helped define the record industry as we know it today. His ability to amplify brands and identify gaps in the market led him to pivot to education, where he recognized the need for better STEM and computer science-based education technology. As executive chairman, CEO, and co-founder of For The Win Robotics, he pioneered the Build, Fly, Code program and released a first-of-its-kind curriculum to schools across the United States. In 2023, For The Win unveiled Hopper, its newest drone, designed for hands-on learning and revolutionizing STEM education by providing the tools to make coding, robotics, and engineering fun and accessible for students. Developed by a team of aerospace, education, and technology experts, Hopper represents the evolution of For The Win's Build, Fly, Code program. Hopper's robust, reusable hardware and software is built around a closed, secure system. The drone, powered by a dual-core processor for communication and flight control, features a lens for advanced computer vision technology, including infrared and color capabilities. Validated through 889 compliance, Hopper empowers educators to expand future additional and hands-on STEM learning to all learners, including underserved communities and students of all abilities. In this edition of the Drone Radio Show, Rob talks about For The Win Robotics, the Hopper drone, and how new drone technology is enhancing STEM education. But before we hear from Rob, I want to stress that your support is the heartbeat of my podcast. Every episode is crafted with you in mind, and your generous donations ensure I can keep delivering the content you love. Whether it's the price of a coffee or a more substantial contribution, every bit helps to defray the cost of production. Donate today and be a vital part of the podcast's continued journey to greatness. And for a limited time, donate $100 or more, and receive an official Drone Radio Show coffee mug. To donate, go to droneradioshow.com/donate. And if you can, please subscribe to the podcast on your favorite platform and leave a nice review and ratings on iTunes. It really helps improve the podcast ranking among the many thousands of active podcasts today. And by the way, if you have a story that you feel would make for a great podcast, contact me at randy@droneradioshow.com. So let's find out how drone technology is making STEM education more accessible and fun with Rob Harvey of For The Wine Robotics. Let's pick up the interview where I asked Rob to introduce himself.
My name is Rob Harvey, and I am the executive chairman and co-founder of FTW Robotics, which stands for the Wine.
Rob, tell us about For The Wine Robotics. What does the company do?
For The Wine Robotics, I would say, is an educational technology or an education technology company. But I know that title gets thrown around a lot. In our case, our education technology is comprised of hardware and software, computer applications, manufacturing, you know, platform building, supporting educators and students. But where our big differentiator is, we own and manufacture and create all of our hardware and software and present the service side of it as well. And our focus technology at this point is drone technology.
How old is the company?
We were founded in 2018.
Who are your primary customers?
So it's funny, our core customer would be educators at any level, you know, the low, medium to high touch, meaning in the classroom, on the ground, versus more the administrative side or like the teams around the country that support through a state kind of program, the elevation of skills for educators, all the way up to senior leadership in districts, head of districts and states, all the way to the heads of states, education departments, and even federal government in their education interests. That does not preclude private, any education institution, even non-for-profits, but the general case or customer case is educator. But the irony is our customer or the end customer for us all are the students themselves. So we don't directly educate, professionally develop, you know, students, but our job and our mission is to upskill and support educators in their further development of their computer science and STEM learning programs. And our focus, again, is drone technology.
Why the focus on drone technology?
To give a little more detail and context around why drone technology, back in 2018, the original founder of this company, Daniel, obviously still here, and he's the chief operating officer now, he found early on that drone technology was an extraordinarily valuable learning platform. In the old days, you know, early days, he was and the team was running around coupling a great high quality education drone with obstacle courses and just the team would sell it into a network or a district or a local school, and they would go in and really allow for teach, stand up, I guess you would say, a drone program back in, you know, 6 years ago. So the zeroing of that point, that the drone technology is a great learning platform, is why we are here still today. And I think it's worth noting that that technology, that piece of hardware, the education drone that we initially started our company on the back of, was not ours. And for the preceding years, all of a sudden, we're in 2021, and we have an extraordinary list of customers, and we've been developing our platform BuildFly code now for several years. And then the chip crisis happened, and our drone became end of life. We could no longer manufacture it. And we had millions of dollars worth of purchase orders. And that's not even the point. Forget the money. We had to then turn around to all of these educators who we've been building relationships with and whatnot, and basically break a promise because we couldn't deliver. There was a lot of disappointment, none more than ours, I think. But what happened at that moment was we said, enough of this. Like, this was out of our control and there was nothing we can do about it right now. But there is something we can do about it. And we went out, started in 2021 late, and we brought everything in-house, Randy. Computer science, engineering, manufacturing, design, everything. And we designed, built, and now manufacture Hopper, which is our 889 compliant, that is part of the National Defense Authorization Act. And that speaks to security and, you know, country and company of origin as it relates to components. So we early on took that, as well as years of previous experience, getting feedback from educators using our other drone. What is it that you want and need? And how can we make that on steroids? And, you know, we're very proud now to say that after 2 years, Hopper's software and hardware is designed and manufactured right here in Southern California in the United States. Hopper's servers are housed right here in, you know, Southern California in the United States. And everything about its security, its reliability, our responsibility to be able to deliver this is secure. So Hopper now being way over and above as an education drone in comparison to anything else, it is very secure, which is not at all about a country thing for us. It's or the political chargedness of some countries' relationships with ours. It's really about our responsibility to deliver the highest quality components and product and service we can. And that starts with the semiconductor that we use as our dual core processor, for example, and everything else we do. So Hopper, after, you know, that history I just shared, now alongside software applications, an entire platform that is community and connection and content, which is called the Build Fly Code platform. So myself and our team and Hopper and everything we do is in service to this platform, which, as we said from the beginning, is that professional development, you know, interest and towards our customer base. We're just trying to bring something that is of the highest quality with an extremely long life. You know, the whole concept of our program is firstly to understand the tool in which you're tasked later on to solve problems with. But now we have no more supply chain issues as it relates to consistency, security, all of the above, because we do it all.
Tell us about the Build Fly Code program. What does it entail?
Build Fly Code is essentially two separate phases, if you will. The students get handed, you know, maybe it's a group of four students, usually it's collaboration in teams, but they get Hopper. Hopper is in a custom case. It's, you know, in there along with its LiPo battery and its LiPo batteries and its chargers, all of which we make, its controller, and the tools that you need to actually build Hopper. Hopper does not come assembled. The only thing that comes assembled on Hopper is the printed circuit board or the PCB. But the students have to not only understand everything on the printed circuit board, the infrared sensors, the camera, whatnot, but build, fly, code, build. They learn how to build it. They learn about all the components, the propellers, which way they're supposed to spin, the motors and whatnot. And then they move into fly, which is mechanical design, piloting skills, aeronautics, aerospace engineering, just kind of a pilot safety, just really understanding you know, even the piloting controls, yaw, pitch, and whatnot. And then from there, the student enters into the code portion, which is what is programming? You know, it's an algorithm, it's a recipe, it's like, you know, base all the way up to the basics of programming to ultimately start off the next phase, which is programming Hopper to solve problems that the next level of build, fly, code presents. And that's where in that area, we get into career technical education, precision delivery, you know, search and rescue, logistics, cinematography, and all those other areas. And just to go back one step, the last thing we teach in build, fly, code in that first phase is disassemble. Because Randy, the one thing we're actually doing in terms of the responsibility of this program and just technology in itself as a tool, we want the students to be able to maintain and manage that tool. You know, understand if they crash and the propeller flies off and the battery gets detached from the printed circuit board, it's nothing but a, okay, we got to stop for a second. You know, once they have a novice working relationship with Hopper, the tool that they are going to be tasked with using to answer the problems they're given, then the wheels come off and it gets incredibly fun.
Currently, how many schools are using the program?
I don't know the total number right now, but the last time we checked, we were in over 1,000 schools. But majority of that was our education drone, but that wasn't ours prior.
I realize Hopper is a new product, but is it available today?
It's in the field right now. It is just now entering the market. We've been talking about Hopper for over a year. We've been developing Hopper for over 2 years. So we have, there's several, I mean, many, because we've been selling pre-orders of Hopper since January of last year. But we've been hiding and being very quiet because we wanted to get developmentally the software and Hopper to the point where we were at innovation level 1 or 1.1.0, and that took a lot longer. It's a lot harder, by the way, to ground up, create a drone design, manufacturing software, company, but we're here now. We needed to make sure the things that we were yet to be able to stand up here in the U.S., battery really was one, the crucial one. We started that a year ago, and we just now found our U.S. manufacturer of completely politically charged, economy-free sourcing of every piece and process and propulsion. And we brought on about 30,000 Hoppers worth to give us a runway for at least, you know, a year or two, I don't know, 3 years. But based on the companies, there are large software companies that want, they're highly interested in being part of this platform, you know, allowing for their software, because they don't have a hardware element, to be part of the platform where any student or educator whom has access, by the way, our access codes, it's a one-time purchase. You know, that price will go up as the platform grows, but right now it's priced at $500, and that educator will never pay again, ever.
How are you going to get existing customers to transition to Hopper as their new educational drone?
When we started back in 21 to develop Hopper, you know, was not Hopper at that point, but me and the original founder, Daniel, the number one thing we have to do, it has to be fully integratable with that drone that we're already, you know, in 1,000 schools with. And right now and forever, any customer, current customer of FTW, whom bought in 2018, 2019, whatever it is, we have what we call Hopper Up, where for an extraordinarily reasonable price, we extend that to their next purchase, because it's literally the next level. So the early adopter, especially where I come from, my previous industry of music, the early adopter is everything, Randy. So I'm glad you brought that up. And we've solved every single angle at it.
How customizable is the curriculum? Or should I ask, What do educators need to know to set up their curriculum around Hopper?
So it depends on the person, right? So you have the one percenter educators out there that, like, we sell a lot of Hopper classroom bundles right off the website, ship them, and we never hear from these people because they take what we give them, which is that access code and an activity set and, you know, all of the resources in on the platform, and they run it, right? They just run. And then you have, I would say, that type of educator, a solo educator who's really buying for his or her or their classroom. They have no idea what they're doing. They always call or we always get on the phone. And it is we're high touch, very high touch, as high touch as desired on the customer side. So we can help design and develop. Firstly, we will professionally develop these educators. We have, you know, production studios here in Southern California where our Zoom game is really extraordinary, multiple camera angles, multiple people. And we make sure the educator, if it's one or 10 or an entire district, when we're working with them, they walk away with everything they possibly need. We professionally develop first. And that can be, like I said, low touch, we don't need you. They usually call anyway. That medium touch where they kind of just need everything, but it's kind of standard. But then we get into districts and state and federal level where we're building out years-long programs. Like the state of Pennsylvania, we've been working with them in their CSMPA Build Fly Code program since 2020, and it's not stopping anytime soon. So that one was much more robust. That incorporated not only our work, but it incorporated their integration into neurodiversity settings and, you know, ensuring that this was equitably distributed throughout their state. So any level of integration or relationship or support that is required, whether it's technical support, the app's not working, software issues, all of it, come to us. That's one of the big differentiators compared to any other product or service out there in our space.
Have you received any interest from universities or community colleges?
We are in discussion right now of working with a very large software company to support their endeavor of bringing their language, software language, into the marketplace through high school and higher education settings. So that is going to happen. You know, we were always focused on K through 12, like let's get that first. But colleges are calling because now, and major software technology companies are calling us because now we have Hopper and we own everything. It's all enclosed. It's our software because you go to the source, there's a source now. So the college and the career technical education establishments as well are all coming into our world because we're able to get into the much, much higher and deeper technology and technical projects and problems to solve.
In terms of building and growing For The Win Robotics, what advice would you give to other entrepreneurs?
In the music industry, they are tasked with finding a spark, finding a connection, a cultural wave. Whether it's an artist, Shawn Mendes or whomever it is, starting as a young artist. And, you know, I was saying before, everyone likes something, but it's that, whoa, that spark. Daniel, the original founder of our company, chief operating officer now, found that spark. We just dove in head first to chase it down. I recommend any entrepreneur to find something that you see that not many other people are seeing and chase it down. But I'll warn you, it's hard. Not easy, but everyone who's gotten that to that point has done it.
So what's next for the Win Robotics?
Even though Hopper's been something we've been talking about for a year and there's plenty of them out there, you know, in the next several weeks, we are going to, for the first time ever, lean in to doing our part and letting people know that we exist. So that means that there's a whole cohort of customers of ours that do not know what's going on, We're going to hit them, our early adopters, first and say, by the way, this is here. Second to that, we're going to just be available, and people are going to, you know, I'm sure social media and whatnot will show things that Hopper is doing and build, you know, continuation of that. But on top of that, we have just recently signed partnerships with some very, very big state, large district all over this country, and, you know, federal as well. So I was going back to full circle on that 30,000 hoppers worth of batteries. We are in a position now where we can turn the lights on and service as much as we think is coming, with a way past 30,000 runway already being paved. So we don't need to go fast, but we are prepared to go at light speed.
And for my final question, Rob, what message would you like to leave regarding the future of the drone industry?
It was really hard to get to this place. It took a lot of guts for us and a lot of significant partners around the country to enable us to get to this place, which is ultimately connecting drone technology at an early age. So all of those who own companies, whether it's Honeywell on down, that all know that the business that they're in is going to be a much bigger industry and a bigger business. What we do is we are doing our best to supply the pipeline, that workforce development pipeline. And it doesn't necessarily have to even be in drone technology. Remember, for us, the drone was the hack, right? Get kids' attention, time spent listening, get them really engaged. Either way, we've created this learning platform to serve this growing industry. And I know that benefits everybody.
That's it for episode 417 of the Drone Radio Show. I hope you enjoyed hearing from Rob Harvey of For The Win Robotics. I want to thank Rob for taking the time to speak with me. If you want to learn more about For The Win Robotics or want to connect with Rob, check out the webpage at ftw-robotics.com. If you like the Drone Radio Show, then please subscribe and share. Write a glowing review on iTunes. And if you're able, donate to keep the podcast going. Go to droneradioshow.com/donate. And thanks for listening. Your support means a lot to me, and I hope you'll listen to more episodes of the Drone Radio Show podcast to hear how others are using drones for business, fun, and research. For the Drone Radio Show, I'm Randy Gores.
This has been the Drone Radio Show podcast. More information on today's show can be found on our website at www.droneradioshow.com. If you're using drone technology for business, fun, or research, and would like to share your experience on the show, please visit our website and fill out a guest appearance application. And don't forget to follow us on your favorite social media channels.